Since the lockdown last year, I've spent a lot of my time in the garden here in Phichit. And I built this lotus pond and a lot of other features, and it's been great fun. So I thought I'd put together a little film showing some of the things I do to encourage wildlife in the garden, and also showing you some of the things that we've seen over the last month or so. This is July 2021. I have a larger pond as well, which I dug out 20 odd years ago. Quite a few fish, water lilies in there. We had a huge crop of baby toads coming out of that during this rainy season this year and last year. Magnolia, jumpy in Thai. We plant a lot of different shrubs and bushes. This is gao that most people in Thailand would recognize. Lovely smell, but insects love it as well. And pikun tree. I'll put the names, the English names below in the description. We have a lot of palms in the garden as well, and they attract a lot of insects. The little bees love them. And also bird's nest. Now, I put this little water dish out last year, even though we have the larger pond, and it is a huge hit with the birds. Here we can see Oriental magpie robin really enjoying being able to bathe in this water. It's up on some little metal legs that I just found in a rubbish heap. Yellow-vented bulbul as well coming in to bathe. Despite our noisy neighbors, I've left the sound on because we get the sound of the birds as well then, and this is a house in the town. Love these birds. Never, to my knowledge, have I seen a nest actually in the garden. Oh, I take that back. There was one time, but it was parasitized by this bird, an Asian coal. Here we are. This is a Carpenteria palm. It's not like the yellow and green palms that are reasonably low and bushy. This one grows on a single, very tall stem, but as you can see, full of fruits at the top all year round, and the coals love these fruits, as do some other birds as well. And there are nearly always nests up there in the top of these palms, especially scaly-breasted munias. But this was the real delight this year. Over the month of July, we had this Malaysian pied fantail nesting in the garden, quite low down. We were watching it for some time, and now obviously, as you can see, the eggs have hatched. There were a couple of little mouths poking up just now for food. Wonderful. Nearby, there was a nest of streak-eared bulbuls, and I watched with delight as first one egg and then a second egg were laid very close to where I was working. But then, the next day I went to look and they were gone. Really quite a surprise. Is this the culprit? Possibly. Golden tree snake, of course, one of the commonest snakes you'll see throughout Thailand, in and out of gardens. They will take eggs, they'll take the chicks. Most often, people post videos online. You see of them in battles with the tokay geckos. This one is actually sitting right by a nest in a lilawadi tree in my garden just outside the window, so I could get a good look at it. Mildly venomous snake. The venom's not of any consequence to humans, but large adults will give you a pretty decent bite. Small ones tend to be fairly passive. And here we are, streak-eared bulbul, one of the pair that were nesting over in the corner. I hope they will start again and make a new nest somewhere in the garden. And the golden tree snake was not the only snake in the garden. We often get these yellow spotted keelbacks. This is a particularly feisty one. Look at that. Feasting, no doubt, on the frogs and toads that have spawned out from our pond. Very, very common species of snake as well. Always find these in and around the garden.
Ow! No, come on. I thought we'd got past that stage. Oh, no, don't bite yourself. Come on. Oh, it really is getting frustrated now. So I'm gonna let this snake go, but I think I should let it go outside our garden because I'm afraid the dogs, if they find this, they'll probably bite it.
Here we are, scaly breasted munias. And a brown-throated sunbird. Look at the gorgeous colours on this bird. And here's the female. This is a different one, the olive-backed sunbird that is very common also in gardens. Back to the nest. This is a week or so later, and as you can see, the chicks are growing fast. Too big for the nest now. The parents being kept very busy bringing insects to these chicks. It's lovely for us because we grow a lot of flowers and vegetables in the garden and fruits deliberately, plants with berries and flowers that will attract insects, and we never spray anything. So it would seem that they can find plenty to eat right here in our garden. This is just another day or two later. And this one, the larger of the two, really seems to prefer to be half out of the nest. Yeah, know that feeling. Can't quite decide whether you want to eat or sleep. One of the parents using the water dish to take a well-earned break. In this clip, I'm using a mixture of footage from a couple of cameras. This is just to use some of that footage up. I've just got a new setup, 4K. And so all this stuff from now on will be recorded in 4K. So we should see a much higher quality of image. And now I think probably this is the next day. It's around the 20th of July. And they've already hopped out of the nest. At this point, my daughter is telling me to keep on recording. We've been filming this bird for a long time, but she is sure that it is going to take its first flight.
There's a parent up there. They can't just keep rolling forever. I mean, you've got to make a choice at some point, change your shot or something, because you're only going to use like 10 seconds out of this.
They're starting to go.
Yeah, they're always starting to go.
And then the other one actually left it, so.
Well, I don't know. I can't see it. They were both. It has gone. All right. Oh, excellent. Well done. We did.
Good girl. She forced me to keep filming there, and we got the shot. That bird's first flight. Now, this is something we do at the end of a hot day, and I would recommend anyone else to do it as well if you have a garden. The birds absolutely love it. We don't just water the garden. We spray onto the plants and the trees. And look at this tailor bird coming to enjoy the shower that we're providing. You'll find at the end of a very hot and sunny day in particular, not too late, but just maybe 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon, you do this, the birds really appreciate it.
I know, I can see it. I've got it. Perfect. I waited on the leaf and it hopped onto the leaf. The tailor bird is smoothing itself on the leaf. Where's the sunbird now? I was doing the same, right?
These tailor birds have actually nested in among the plant that you can see that it is gripping onto there. This is a water plant at the end of my pond. One of the best things I ever did was to make an area out of the pond as basically like an island or a peninsula with soil in, and then planted these water plants. Tailor birds frequently nest in there, but also there are little pools concealed in there where frogs and toads can lay eggs and the tadpoles can develop without being eaten by the large fish that live in the main part of the pond.
Yeah. That's great.
So I've left the original sound running. You can hear the speaking that's going on between myself and my daughter, helping each other identify the birds. Look at this. The female of a sunbird. If somebody can please tell me what one this is. I'm a little confused by this one, but she is having a great time in this shower. And showers are too good to take alone. In comes a fantail crashing in. Who says males can't multitask? Look at this guy. A beak full of food for one of the offspring there, taking a bath and calling all at the same time. I've noticed that different birds have different styles. The fantail is quite happy to get right in amongst the water on the shower. Here, the male olive-backed sunbird, possibly the same one we saw earlier. Look at the way it pokes its tongue out as well. It's had a shower and it's now kind of preening and drying itself off. And then, the day after we saw the birds fly from the nest, we've found them in the morning in the garden, and how is that for cuteness? Staying close together, what they're accustomed to, just watching the tree and the sky for any sign of a parent bird bringing food. actually. I'm so pleased. This is on a tree that was very tall. Was a mistake to plant it in the middle of the garden next to the pond. But I took a chance on it, and instead of cutting it down, I've just pollarded it at around about 3 meters height. And it's pushed out a lovely crown of smaller branches. So we still have a nice big trunk at the base. And then of all things, on about the third day after these young birds left the nest, one of them actually came into the house and has ended up here on my mug next to the kitchen sink.
Yeah.
Anyway, thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.